How many of us have been part of a skirmish or an outright bitter fight in our neighborhood over a car parking spot? I doubt if anyone living in Delhi, Bangalore, or Mumbai has escaped that very unsavory, totally avoidable experience. So it's obvious to all of us that our cities have an unsustainable parking mess with growing number of private vehicles on the roads, leading to air pollution, which puts all our health at high risk. If it's so obvious, then why stall the report submitted by EPCA, which has come out with the rules to manage Delhi's parking requirements? Anumita, we've covered a lot of ground before the break. Just wanted to understand, here you have a pretty smart parking policy, but you also have a lack of public transportation. I mean, the Delhi government hasn't even bought the buses that it has been saying that it will in the last 2 years. We have probably the lowest density of buses to population in any capital city of the world. How do you resolve it? I mean, you have parking charges, but you don't have enough public transportation.
You're very right. No. So, you know, this argument that we do not have enough public transport is also not always very well explained. And I'll tell you why. What the parking policy is going to do, it's not that the moment you start talking about the parking policy and enforce it, that people are going to jump out of the car and try to board a bus. What it does is forces people to think through many other options. So which would mean that if you have a parking constraint and you have to pay for it, then you will consider combining your trips so that you make less car trips from the family. Then you will do carpooling. You will then take Ola, Uber, or you will then take a metro, or you will walk. So there are so many different possibilities and opportunities that open up, which reduces the motorized travel, the personal motorized travel of the people. And yes, of course, simultaneously, you will have to scale up public transport. But then you cannot make it a chicken and egg problem. So what pricing policy is going to do, and that is more important to understand, that it is going to force people to think of many different options.
I agree.
That can help to reduce the car trip. But more important, it's pricing and management together. Because a lot of, I just heard an argument right now that we do not have enough parking places. You can never have enough parking spaces. But what good parking management does is that whatever parking spaces are available in the city, you will optimize it the best. We have seen from studies in Bhikaji Kama, in Nehru Place, in many other places, that the moment you start reorganizing the parking space properly, we found that the parking supply was actually higher than parking demand. But it was not being properly utilized because of bad management. So therefore, the combination of strategies are needed today.
I agree with you. In fact, your Jasola case study was extremely, eye-opening. There's an excess of parking supply. It's just the question of what sort of vehicles are parked. 90% of the vehicles are private vehicles, which are just taking up the spaces. Here you have Delhi government saying, where do we have parking? So how do we procure buses? So it's a much larger question, whether it's political or not. But I'm going to go back to Professor Mishra. You were talking about Mumbai. Sure enough, Mumbai has a great policy. But then you talk about the fact that you still don't have enough parking spaces within residential accommodations because everyone has 4 to 5 cars. So do you believe that public parking at least is the worst form of land grabbing and has to be made or brought at par with, let's say, some of the best countries or in the world, London or even New York?
No, see, I would here put up an argument that if you have a traffic management plan and if you have a parking app that helps you reorganize parking, I think it's a good thing to go ahead. The other thing is you should have an intermediary public transport system. For example, if I come to Delhi, and if I have to go to India Habitat Center, I prefer to take a metro, get down at Zorbagh, take a cycle rickshaw and reach it comfortably. I would not like to take Uber or Ola to reach any place in Delhi. The other thing is, why congest the road myself? I should have a civic responsibility to see that if I'm using my public transport and if traffic management is not in place, how do I reduce time for myself? I think it is unless people themselves understand the options of reaching a place without having to park and without looking for a taxi, I think it will solve a problem in a big way.
All right. Mr. Atul, Are the residents completely comfortable if the parking policy is implemented? I mean, if Supreme Court makes it a non-negotiable factor, do you think that RWAs will sit down with the municipal authorities and start working out on better parking management?
You will find mixed reactions over with the RWAs particularly. Few colonies are going to support this movement, few colonies are going to oppose this movement. Because the interests are different and the policies are different, the people living in the whole of the city are different strata of life, and there are categories of colonies where people are living in slums, they do have the cars, people are living in the high-end colonies, they do have the cars. The only thing is we need to make a balance between the people who own a car and their right to park it on the roadside. I cannot oppose a vendor sitting in front of my house or office who is occupying a public space, and I cannot claim that I have a right to park my car in front of my house. So we need to make a balance between the two, and the government has to come up with certain unpopular steps towards decongestion of the city and making the city more mobile. And unless they come up with the parking charges and all these things, things will not improve in particularly Delhi.
So, Mr. Atul Goyal, you've said exactly what we are all been wanting to say but have been restraining ourselves. These are unpopular political decisions. Implementation, Amit Bhatt, final word. Can we implement this policy? Is it that hard? Because we haven't even been able to implement waste segregation in the city.
To me, this is much more simpler than waste.
Okay.
If we are able to get the political will, we can do it. We should start with elementary pricing and eventually look at dynamic pricing. Because once you have dynamic pricing, which is linked to the amount of parking which is available, the prices fluctuate. And we have seen San Francisco and all do wonders with the same amount of parking space, but only playing with the pricing.
Doable. So it is doable. It just needs political will. Anwita Roy Chaudhary, Rajiv Mishra, Amit Bhatt and Mr. Atul Goyal, thank you. We had all the stakeholders, different voices telling us why paid parking has to become a norm rather than an exception. It will put an end to the worst form of land grabbing by the well-to-do. The more cars you have, the more public land you occupy. And we are heading for big trouble if we don't start with the capital city, which is Delhi, and then, of course, go across India to make it happen in all our cities. Thank you very much for joining me on Urban Reality today.